Exactly.
You see me wear sunglasses one time in your life, but you never at any show. We've done about 20 shows, and at 20 shows, you never see me wear sunglasses.
I haven't seen you do it anymore. That was my point. Not, I said, did it feel right to you? And you made an excuse. It didn't feel right. No. I can't help that you wear prescription glasses. I ain't ask you all that. That's cool. Yeah. I'm talking about the ones that don't wear prescription glasses that fade into the dark and all that.
Yeah.
That's the ones I don't like.
Yeah.
Man, you are not Hollywood, and you are not.
I'm not wearing my senior glasses to clubs no more, dog. No, I'm not feeling it.
I'm not condoning it, and I'm not even. No. Yeah, not.
No. You know what the thing is, though, man. I'm afraid to get contacts, man. I'm scared they're gonna fall in my eye, dog.
Hey, Ike, we're over it already. That's for them lames that do that.
I got some few more questions, man. Shows. You got shows coming up. You got anything you want to promote? Shows that you're getting into.
I don't have any shows. And you know why? I think it's for the same reason what you just told me. I think some people take it too personal. I actually think that a lot of people don't have me on their shows because I work harder than them.
Yeah.
And I make it look easy. So they don't want to get outshined on their show. And I refuse to pay to be on anyone's show. I'm an MC, and I work hard, and I pay for all my music I do to do this. I don't pay to be on your show to make your show fresher.
Yeah.
I go rap in my garage and have more people over here, and they go hard in the yard.
Yeah.
That's how my confidence is and what I do with my music. I refuse to pay. Man, I body people's features. There's so many features people didn't put out that I kill their music. I don't half-ass on nothing.
Yeah.
As hard as I go on my music, a feature for you, I'm a body it. Ain't I can't think of one person that paid me for a feature, and I know I have over 150.
Yeah, and that's some work. You put in some work, man.
And they go hard. And people don't know how hard I work.
And you're probably like me. You probably got 150 people waiting on verses, man. And
they're too scared to ask me for them.
Man, I
don't know why. Because they're not keeping it real. Yeah. That's what it is. I'm like, I wish there was 100 people waiting on me to do a verse for them.
When I'm ready, when I'm set up to do it, man, and we both got time, we're doing it, man. That's the way I work. I just haven't had no time, man. But we're gonna get it together, man. We talked about it a little bit, but we never got full detail into it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's how I work. If somebody wants me on Mason, I'm gonna give you 200% like it's my own song.
Yeah.
Regardless,
guaranteed. You pay me for it.
I don't know what I can tell you better than that, because I'm gonna still give the effort. If it wasn't, I'm gonna go just as hard, or I'm gonna get back to you so fast you won't believe it.
Yeah.
And you'll be like, man, I'm more than happy. Like, this guy's a beast, and I am. I'm a beast. I'm a monster. I'm not one to play with on the mic. I'm cold blooded. F. I caught myself again. I'm not the one for it.
Yeah.
I'm not the one for it. And I mean, I can get it. I'll get whoever, your crew, whatever. If you want to go real rhyming, bars, everything, never mind the gang stuff and all that. Because I'm telling you, man, I rhyme so mean, I will make you want to shoot me. I'll make you want to kill me.
You don't have to convince me. I already heard you. I already know.
Man, did you hear the song I did called How to Rob when I redid 50 Cent's song? That's why nobody messes with me.
Yeah.
Man, I roasted everybody in Denver, and you know what? Nobody replied and roasted me back. I've been in rooms with all the niggas that I roasted on that song, and they gave me respect. I was like, man, that's tight. But you know what? Anybody put my name in a rhyme, I'm going to do you.
Yeah.
Wyman, I'm gonna stop everything I'm doing, and I'm destroying you, your label, your teammates, your logos, all that. Mm. I'm gonna stop every. When I see it's gonna be on site, like we're shooting at each other, it's gonna seem like gangbang, but it's gonna be music. Like, oh, I'm gonna stop. Hey, who's performing tonight? Give me the mic. I'm gonna roast him. It'll turn into a fist fight.
Yeah.
I'm serious about what I'm doing, my rhyming, and everybody out here faking gangster and doing all that stuff, man. Don't gangster ain't gonna get you nothing but dead.
Hey man, you know what later, I do, man. Later I hustle
on the go. Jail and dead. Hey, yeah. Do you? Yeah. Don't try to do too much, man. Yeah. Keep it real with
yourself. You're making a real good point, and I want to put that out there, man. You know, a lot of these rappers out here that they come up as gangsters, man, and yeah. Gangsters don't live long, man. Or they go to the pinta. You know, we don't want to see that. Yeah. Man. That's why I run this mentor program. Just to put this out there right now, and I run this mentor program, and I mentor younger rappers. Especially gangbangers that are rapping, you know, just so they slide over just to the rap side and just they don't need to really be in the gang scene if they want to. You know, I'm talking to 19-year-old, 20-year-old.
I want to do stuff like that. People don't know that about me. Yeah. I want to do stuff like that.
Yeah, I've been spoke to a thousand kids like that. And you know what I'm more proud of out of it. Not pride, but humble. Out of it is that at least a couple of them 100 kids have graduated. They're in college and about to graduate from college and don't even care about gangbanging or rapping no more. And that's what I'm more proud of. Yeah. But you got to remember, I've been a coach for 15 years, man. So I've coached thousands of kids, man. So that's cool that you brought that up to not mix the gangbanging in with the rapping, you know what I'm saying? But so, you know, some people, that's their thing. You got it. That's it. That's what they do. That's how their following is based on. But you know, I do try the younger kid. Once people are at a certain age and they can't be told nothing, everything is what the way they see it. That's cool. I won't bother them. But when they're young kids and they're a little more, you can influence them a little more. You can talk to them and you can guide them in the right direction, man. And that's why I said, I got 300-400 kids in college right now that I helped get into college, you know?
That's dope. Yeah, that's kind of stuff I'm on. Like, I have a mentor of mine where, man, he had people, man, I'm from Topeka, Kansas, where niggas are getting killed every day around there. And everybody's like, you're from Kansas City? And I'm like, no. I'm from Topeka, Kansas. Where's that? It's the capital of Kansas. This is how dumbed down everybody is. Man, you can ask somebody tomorrow, the gangster is hardest nigga you know. Whoop-de-whoop. I bet you they can't name the 50 capitals of these states.
I could tell you one person.
I bet you they can't.
One person who could, because we had a show booked there last month, and he wouldn't go back because he beat a case out there. And you know who I'm talking about, so.
You know what I'm saying?
That's where he's
there
from.
There is few, and when I say few, you said I know one.
Yeah, I know one.
You're the only guy, and look how quick you responded, because I believe you out the gate, like, yep, outside of that, nope, I don't think anybody else can name that.
We were all set, booked out there, and he told me he ain't going. I said, dang.
you could offer somebody $500, name all 50 capitals. They wouldn't get it.
Nah, he got kicked out the state though, so by the law.
Oh, I got people that have to. Man, Ike, have you ever thought of that? What are you doing that? They don't even send you to prison, they kick you out of the state.
I don't know like, how that happens, but that's how
I have friends that the same thing is happening. I'm like, what were you doing if you were just a straight menace? Well, they're like, we can't even lock him up. You can't. No, I don't care. Any part of this state, you can't be here. We're sending you to prison.
That's the craziest thing. Oh my gosh. I remember being like third, fourth grade when the Crips came out here, the Crips and the Bloods. And the story was, and it was written up, the state, they were kicked out of California. That's how come they had to come out here.
I remember that thing.
You know, they got kicked out of California.
I was in Kansas still.
Yeah.
I was in Kansas back then, so I remember they were kicking them to
Kansas, they were kicking them to Texas, they were kicking them to Denver.
Oh, yeah. They were everywhere.
So that's how all of them got around like that, you know. And now it's with all the gangs. They get kicked out, you know. The music thing is a business thing to me. So like the gangbang and stuff, man. I just leave that to the side. Like the people who want to do it, that's their life, and that's what they're gonna lead. And that's cool if they're doing it with music and they're doing a positive route. Let's do it. Let's roll. You know, I work with different kinds of gangs. You know what I'm saying? Like. As far as the music goes, it really don't, you know, I really don't, like, I'm not just one-sided with one kind of gang, you know what I'm saying? You've been to the show, you've seen Crips, Bloods, everybody there, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And nobody got in a fight or nothing, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It's because I work and I talk with people and I try to explain to them, you know, this is a show, we're trying to do this more, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I had to reiterate that with partners of mine when I moved out here, where I was used to that, where I'm from. Oh yeah, it's going down. Like, yeah, it's going to be pistol play, whatever and everything. And nobody cared about that because they was already hustling. They already had their money. They was doing that just to, you know, claim that. But out here, I was like, man, we can't be out here fighting people or fighting each other. Why would I wouldn't come to your show if I know it's notorious for fighting and shooting. And people get sucked up into that thinking that's gangster shit.
See, when I first became a promoter way back when I was younger.
You're killing your own money. You're killing your own money when that happens.
I had thousands of people show up to the show.
You've seen it all. I'll tell you where you said back in the day, you're a vet. You seen it at a young age where you're like, yeah, I know where this is going to go. No, ain't gonna waste my bread, but I know what to invest in.
So I know which way to go, you know what I mean? So I don't mind having small shows. I don't mind them, you know what I mean? Because it gives artists to practice. It gives artists to practice a little bit, and they still get some fans out to see them, and everybody has a good time. You know, I don't know. Maybe my son wants to go into promoting, and he wants to do events, festivals, and things of that nature. Right. So it's something we're looking into right now. So it's something to keep an eye out for. The idea is with my son Ike Jr., my youngest son. That's what he's interested in. He's been going to these festivals, checking them out, meeting the promoters and everything. So. It could come to fruition pretty soon, so be on the lookout for that. I don't know.
The rap game needs more of that and less rappers. More promoters, more businessmen, more CEOs, and less rappers.
Yeah, I have all my sons.
I said it first, kill the hun. Yeah. A lot of you niggas are garbage out there, and your best friends keep pumping you up with that shit. I'm sorry, cussing him, but it's just trail shit. Man, it's garbage. You're not doing your friends no favor by being a yes man in the garbage. Do something else.
One good thing, though, is I have five boys, and none of them are rappers, man.
Man, my son's a rapper. And he was straight garbage when he was younger.
My man
got 2 years older. Man, he's a beast. Where even my homeboys, where I say, hey, man, you got to listen to this song my son and his friend did. My homeboy, word up to my homeboy, Frank Lopez, he from Hardhead Records. He goes, man, did you write it for him? I'm like, nope. He goes, I don't want to hear it. Turn laughing. I'm like, that's cold-blooded. He goes, no, I'm just kidding. Man, my man impressed me where I call my man, you made me proud. I'm like, dude, because before I'm like, man, you got a heavy torch to carry for Kill of the Hunt, and you don't know. Dude, I started to get in Denver, and my son, I think I'm in his top five, I hope.
I'm not in none of my kids' top five. I don't know that.
I'm in his top five or ten, whatever. He's like, that's just pops. Like, he gets busy like that. He don't count.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy.
That's dope you said that.
I hope it means something. I hope it means something to you. You know what I mean? Cause
I'm hoping I'm in your top three.
I know. I know a lot of. I know.